สวัสดีครับ Good morning on Wednesday 27 January 2021st of this year. Welcoming again back to our training course organized by Office of Industrial Economic in collaboration with National Food Institute under the Ministry of Industry of Thailand on the training course Training to Enhance Manufacturing Technology and Green Productivity in Rice Mill Factory, funded by Thailand International Cooperation Agency. My name is Chan Kansi. I will be your facilitator and moderator again today throughout the training course. Our lecture today is topic number 2 of on the technology of rice mill. To be with us today, we have the knowledge people from Kazakhstan University. In Thai name, Kazakhstan is mean agriculture. So this university is very keen, famous for agricultural fields. Our lecturer today, she is a professor in Kazakhstan University. She obtained a PhD in engineering on energy technology and Master's degree of Engineering in Energy Technologies as well. For Bachelor degree, she obtained the Bachelor of Engineering in Agricultural Engineering. She has many publications regarding to the technology of the productivity, especially in rice. And she also attend various seminar and conference, both in domestic and internationally. Today, participants, colleagues around the world, please welcome Assistant Professor Don Liddy Chai, or Dr. Don Liddy. Good morning, Dr. Liddy.
Good morning.
Good morning, everyone. I heard that some of you is in other part of the world, like in afternoon, good afternoon, and also good evening for everyone. Hope everyone be in safe in your country. Before I start my lecture, may I take a rest? So in Thailand, when you go out and then go to
everywhere, you have to
wear a mask. This is the normal, like for sanitizer. So because we have to talk, like we are in the same room, so we should have to see each other first. So my name is Don Liddy once again, but you can call me Don. I'm from Kazakhstan University. I think that some of you maybe know about Kazakhstan University already. And because every year we have a lot of a training course, maybe some of you had ever joined the course in Kazakhstan University, right? Today I have one top two topic to share. I don't want to call it lecture, but would like to share some experience in terms of rice mill with your guys. Rice is staple foods, not only from Thailand, but is I think it's around most of the country that joined today, like it's staple foods for your country as well. Are you ready for starting?
Yes, ready.
I can see guys via the Zoom chat. And maybe if you have any question or would like to share your experience, please feel free and don't hesitate to share your question or your experience or your opinions in the chat. And I will repeat and then I will reread it again and then answer your question later. I hope the situation of COVID-19 will recover soon and then we may see each other face to face in the near future. Okay, we may start the first topic of today. Can you show? Yes. In the development of rice mill technology in Thailand. Actually, Thailand We export rice in like I can say the top five of the world export to other country. You may know the rice of Thai that in terms of aromatic rice, or we call jasmine rice, right? The jasmine rice, I went to many countries around the world because of I myself also work in for international affairs for the university as well. So once I visit in each country, I visit in many countries of your country on the list as well. So once I visit in your country, I can see the rice from Thailand also in the supermarket sometime. It means that you can have experience from Thai rice already. When we talk about the technologies in rice meal, I think in many countries already have, but we can categorize not only in the commercial one, but in Thailand also have the equipment that's similar to your country for the community level. So we will share in the afternoon how the traditional and modern rice meal in Thailand, how we work and what kind of equipment that we have. But today I will start with this is one picture that I took in one part of Thailand when I went to the province. We still have like this. We still have the actually in Thailand we grow in many parts of Thailand. Nearly every part of Thailand can grow rice. So that by the production is pretty high, and also we use a lot of technology at the moment. Not only the equipment, but as you know, right now the trend of using the technology changed already, right? We not only use the equipment tools, but we link the equipment to with the application also. But that one maybe is a bit far in some area. But Thailand already use, and we prepare that we have the big data project, which is my university also one of the part of big data project on that. And we link between that kind of the data before the COVID-19 situation happened, so we can do some application on the mobile.
As you know, as you see on the screen that I show you the graph of the country that produces the production, not it means in each country can produce how much of the rice previous. You can see the graph, the China is number one, but however they consume quite a lot in their country. So when we talk about the exporting, the China maybe not it's not mean the index of the exporting. So Thailand also can produce. The production is in with many factors, for example, what kind of environment, what kind of equipment, what kind of how many areas, something like that. It have many factors that we have to concern about the production. The next slide will be the next slide. I show you the consumption in European Union. You can see Thailand also export to many countries. European also one of the area that we export rice to, and we export even to your country in Africa, in other part, even in Asia also. So I have visit Philippines many times because we have the collaboration, and I have friends in Philippines quite a lot. So Philippines also consume some of the Thai rice over there. even then they can produce their own rice very low, and they have the World Institute. You may know the IRI, right? IRRI is in Philippines, Los Banos. And before we go to the equipment, we may see how different sort of rice in different variety. Maybe most of you already see of them, but some of you maybe can see some of them. The first one is Rakan rice or the Rakan rice. Homery also include in this kind of variety. So we are in the wrong game when you categorize the size by the size. Homery is in wrong game and have the smell. So that's why they aromatic. So that's why they call Rakan rice. But if you move to China, to Japan, to Taiwan, they have their own life, but it is different. The shapes. So in that country, they consume the short and medium grain, right? And what is different? It's different from the, you know, like in function inside the rice, right? Maybe I think all of you know about this. And the third one, we call the glutinous rice. Thailand also can produce the glutinous rice, and we consume quite a lot also in Thailand as well, especially in northeast of Thailand. They can produce and they consume quite a lot over there. And in the bottom rice, the first one we call Pabon rice. Why we call Pabon rice? This one, they use the steam and they use the thermal and heat up and change the function inside the rice and became the power rice. And we export power, you know, in Thailand we export power rice quite a lot to many parts of the world as well. Not only normal rice, but also the power rice can make the benefit for Thailand quite a lot as well. In the middle is porticoes, I think. Yeah, some of you already consume because it's from the country. When you mill rice, you get what kind? Can you sort it? When you mill rice, you can get the head, white rice, right? Which one, the first one? Not the number one. When you harvest, and then you bring your paddy into the rice mill, the first one should be like number four rice. And then when number four, and then start from number four, and then maybe you get the brown rice, right? You get the brown rice. After you whiten it, you get the rice bran out, the number five, and then it will be together, head rice and broken rice together. You have to use the equipment, which I will tell you later, to separate between head rice and broken rice. And you know the physical of the rice inside. Once you get the patty 100% and you mill it, you will get the husk 20%, brown rice 80%, and then you get white rice. Sometimes if it's very good milling process, you can get like 70% of them. But for the aromatic like jasmine rice, because it's not quite hard. When you check the hardness, it's maybe lower than the rice in some variety. So when you mill it, is maybe get the lower percentage. This is normal. But however, we can use the technologies to improve the percentage of it. One of the technology that we improve the percentage of head rice yield, as you, I show you, we call the parboiled rice. For the parboiled rice, once you take the process and pass the process of parboiled rice, the head rice yield will be get higher because of the steam will melt the structure inside the rice, and then I will show you later for the picture. So I will explain via the picture later. Okay, I will get into the some equipment. This is just show you some equipment that then we normally use inside the rice mill. The first one you may see in the commercial one, the big one. But however, for the traditional, it will be included in the same equipment. This will in the afternoon you will see. The first one we call the stoning. Of course, when you harvest from the field, you cannot get very clean rice, right? Many things is will come with your rice, your paddy. For example, stone, the other thing that you don't want it. So in the commercial, they normally use this kind of equipment as one part of the post-dice processing. So for the de-stoning, I would like to tell you that once you design the equipment, it have two main things, like different two things, like for the designing. One that you can separate the other thing with rice by using the sizing. We call sizing different size of rice and different size of stone, for example. So they use the sizing idea for design. But for the husks, you cannot use the sizing because it's very lightweight. So that one they design by using bi-weight. So we call bi-sizing and bi-weight. Okay, this is the main idea of when you design the equipment. As you see in the picture, so it will have the sieve, right? Sieve where we vibrate, and then the size, the stone and the rice will be separate by what? Sizing or weight? Sizing, right? You see on the sieve, sizing. So this one you will see in the brief video later in the afternoon. I will show you the big company, one of the big company in Thailand that produce rice. Okay, the second one, this is you very very familiar with it, the husker. Or once you get the paddy inside into your rice mill, you get the husker, like take the branch, take the husk out. The method of the deciding of this one only have normally they have two lower, right? One is we call reader, and the other one we call follower. One will the speed is faster, but the other one is slower. You cannot decide in the same speed, right? Because if it's the same speed, you will get the paddy. You put the paddy in, you get paddy out if it's the same speed. But one is different speed. you if you take the husk out from the paddy. But very important thing for designing of this one is, you know, you see the difference, the pit between the two dollar. If you decide is too close, what will you get? You get the broken, the broken one. But once you decide is too wide, what will you get? You get this paddy. It's not hugs. The hugs is not get it out, right? So very important is we call pit the distance between two roller. So when you use it, when you process it and use it for a long time, the roller they have their own shelf life. So once they use it, you have to change the they have two choices for you. One, you change the whole roller, but normally they will not do it. We just change the rubber on the roller and then use it a few times. If roller is cannot work well, so we can change. So this way I can save it. So normally in Thailand we change the rubber on the roller instead of change whole the roller. Okay, and we can easy right now. We can easy buy the rubber on the which is cover on the roller very easy in Thailand. The next one is the wider machines. This one they have you can see the two shapes, like one is vertical and one is horizontal. So for me the capacity and performance is not quite different for, because of I can see some rice mill they use the vertical one, but there's some rice mill they use the horizontal one. But for the main idea for this one, so once you put the rice inside, is you have the abrasive and also the sieve, right? When is run, so abrasive and also the is you take the branch out, and then the branch will come out from the rice. And the important thing is the times of working, operating, because if you take too long, what will happen? You get powder, you lost your weight on your rice, it means lost your money in your pocket. So this one very important point, because I also work with the Japanese University, Kyoto University in Japan, and we work about this one. How deep of the whitening from the bronze into the until the surface of white rice, because in Japan very serious, because sometimes they take the rice for the to making sake as well. So this is very important thing for them as well. So I will show you for my research later that we right now we use the advanced technique for doing this thing already. Of course, if you write whitening is to be white rice, but you cannot sell it immediately, right? Why? Because of because everyone will familiar with when you buy rice in the supermarket and you see on the rice on the back, if it's not glossy, do you buy it? For Thailand, the people very familiar with the glossy of the surface. So before you finish, you have to do the gloss, make it glossy, right? To use the glossy machine. This one, the idea or the idea is quite the same with the whitening, but different. Not use the abrasive, but use the later, right? Later. So you don't need to take the brown out, but you just polish, light polish on the surface. So you use the glossy machine, right, in the picture. This is the horizontal, right? Horizontal, but also have the vertical. Okay, it depend on you choose this, which one you choose. But I can see in both model in the rice mill. Next is the grading machine. Once you already polish and make it glossy, you cannot sell immediately because of it will have broken, it will have head rice together. So you have to separate using the grading machine. The grading machine, you have to choose the suitable sieve size. Okay, adjust the rotating speed and inclination angles. Very, very, very important when you install it into your rice mill. For this one, they use the main idea is like a sizing, right? In Thailand, when we go to the supermarket, sometimes you will see homery 5%. It doesn't mean only have the homery rice 5%, but it include broken 5% inside. Most 95% is head rice and 5% is broken rice. This can be able in Thailand, but the price is lower. If you buy the 100%, the price is higher. I think in your country maybe the same. The next one is cleaning machine. The cleaning this one, both in using the white the weight and also the sizing for this one. For the weight, you will have the blower, right? Using the blower, and also it's very important that you decide the speed of your air. Otherwise, if you blow rice, instead of just the halves or something, and also you decide once you pass the weight, and then it will come to the sizing. So this is we call the rice cleaning machine, using the main idea of both of them. The next one is we call rice color sorter. This is normally used in the commercial one, because the price pretty high. Traditional cannot afford it, but once you want to export to other country and you have to meet the standard, you may have to use this one. This one, what is the idea? You can see in the slide that have start from the first one is hopper, and then you The patty, the rice will pass from the hopper and then come to the part, the area of the camera. It will detect one by one. You know, I will show you the quick video after this. It will come one by one. It means by in the very, very quick part of second. Once your rice come into the machine, it will detect by camera, and then the system will they will see if you set up the chart, like for example white, dark 0 until white to 10, which you set up the white and the white one, the index about 4, for example 0 to 10, okay, you set at 4. Once is 4 mid to your set up, it will pass. But if it dark or if it not fit into your condition, it will have the air blow very quick, like it. That rice seed will go out from the system. But it's very, very quick, like part of the second. So I will show you for the quick video. This one. Machine also popular one, this one. Even in Thailand, only can absorb this one for the commercial. Okay. The equipment that some parts of equipment which we will see again in the afternoon. But before we go to other part, I will give you some idea for what kind of quality that normally when you take your patty and sell your patty in rice mill. So the quality, the first one is grain translucency. As you are, it means your rice should be translucency when you see pass, like the rice should be can pass your rice. That one is the criteria. The next one is the chalky grain. Chalky grain. This one sometimes is actually is also depend on the variety as well for chalky grain. Thai variety. Rice of Thai variety, we have very rare chalky grain, so we don't have much of a problem about this. But once you sell it, they will check if you have the and the criteria and the condition, which is Erie. You can see, you know Erie, right? This is the biggest institute of rice in the world. Erie, they have the 6 level. The first one 0, right? The second one 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can see if you rise have chalky cane like number 5, you cannot, the rice mill cannot accept it, so they will check your rice before you sell for them. And the next one is grain dimension. The grain dimension, as I told you, is different. Like jasmine rice is in long grain, and for the Japanese rice is in short grain. Basmati, you know basmati rice? That's one very long grain. I had ever visited Africa, and then I taste the basmati. It's good for your kind of food and very delicious as well. But however, the texture is harder when compared to the jasmine rice. The next one is whiteness. Whiteness is they have the equipment, the tester. You can see the first one. In the first picture, you have the white one. That one is the whiteness meter. The whiteness meter is very easy to use. Once you would like to measure it, you take your eye, and it will have the calibration between dark, black, and white. And then it will remember similar to color sorter, but color sorter is not only black and white. Color sorter is can detect the other color as well. Okay. But if you would like to check only whiteness, so use this kind of equipment. They have the scale between dark and white, and then you set up the scale that you want. And then you put the rice inside, and you press it, and then it will show. For example, 46.8 something. This is the percentage of it. The next one is moisture content. This is normal, but moisture content they can measure using many equipment. The first one in the blue one, they call the single grain. Single grain, this means you use only one grain, put it in, and then you squeeze it. It will show you automatically. All of these using the electric method. So the different water inside the grain, it will show. Okay. The other one on the black and red, that one you can measure by bulk. Yeah, bulk. So the results, it will show you also how many percent of the moisture. But within the meal, the big one, you cannot use only that one. Right now they have the sensor. I also produce the temperature sensor using in some equipment in my laboratory. Once you have probe, the sensor temperature probe, you put inside your rice meal on your rice mark, and then in the past you have to check by yourself, right? You have to check by yourself. But right now it have one box that can link between that temperature sensor and your mobile. So you don't need to see by yourself in that press, but you can go everywhere and check it via your mobile phone. Very easy, and it's real time, as it can be recorded, and also I also write it can be show graph on your screen and record for for a moment for the temperature and also not only temperature, relative humidity also can do it. So very easy at the moment. So one only have internet, you can do anything, right? I believe that you may say in some parts of how can we do, because in Thailand also have the hill type, also have the remote area in Thailand, but government, they put the infrastructure about the internet around Thailand, so most of the area can use the internet. But not only I didn't see that Thailand is good for this one much, but I visit Vietnam also very good, because last time I visit Vietnam to see the research about the cassava, and it's built on the hill, but I can detect by using my mobile phone, so it's made very good. And also talk with friends in many countries, they also can use, but you need to write the software to bring between the sensor and this one. Or if you buy it right now, it can it help also, but in some function of software you have to change it for suit to your work. Okay, I will give you some idea. If you have your rice mill, even traditional or commercial, whatever, what kind of quality determination you can determine, you can determine it. The first one, once you have, you can test it like weight. 250 gram. If you want to know how much for the head values of your rice, so you can weigh 250 gram of clean paddy. Okay, you can follow me, and then maybe you can assume some digit, some number, and then maybe try to calculate with me. Okay, so next time you can have experience. Okay. Once you would like to know the percentage of head ratio, broken rice, the percentage of milling recovery, first you have to weigh 250 grams of creamed paddy, and then take the husk out using the machine, the husker tester machines, 3 times. Weigh again for bar rice, and then you whitening it using the abrasive mill tester for 60 seconds. This is already researched that 60 seconds is enough and suitable, followed by the standard. And then you weigh bar rice, you weigh rice that receive, sorry, this is the normal rice, not brown rice. Then separate broken and the head rice by using the grading tester for 60 seconds, and then weigh broken and head rice that you receive. And then you can calculate the percentage of milling recovery. You can calculate percentage of head rice, and then you can calculate the percentage of broken grain. Using this kind of this one, so the percentage of milling recovery, if you can assume the number and then try to calculate for with me, okay. The first one, if you would like to know the percentage of recovery, so you bring the weight, you have weight of new rice, and then you multiply by weight of paddy, and then you divide by the base of Patty and multiply by 100. Okay? So you get percentage of mulling recovery. If you would like to know the percentage of head rise, so you put the weight of whole brain and then divide by weight of Patty and then multiply by 100, you get percentage of head right. For the broken line, the same, but you use the weight of broken brain instead of the weight of the head right, that the whole brain, okay? So you can get the percentage of broken right. For this thing, you get, you will know the efficiency of your machine. First, okay, how many percent of rice? How many percent of your rice that you produce? Okay. To make sure of whiteness, using the whiteness meter, as I show you. So how can you use it? So you get 100 grams of grain head brown rice and head new rice. Okay. Using 100 grain of sampling device, okay, and then you calculate by calculate a yielding degree of new rice using this one 100 gram of weight, gram base of brown rice minus with 100 gram base of new rice, and then you divide by 100 gram base of our rice, and then you multiply by 100, you will get the milling degree. Okay, you can now calculate, and then you will put in the table together later. Okay, to make sure 10 grains dimension is between length and volume. Okay, so using vernier caliper. You know vernier caliper, right? Is where is is similar to the ruler, but is more complicated and more accurate. The accuracy is, yeah. So you can get the shapes like L review ratio, length and Y ratio. You can get it from average length of rice in millimeter, because that is very small, right? And divide by average Y of rice. So you can get the ratio of it. Very easy. Okay. This is the formula that very normal, you can do it in your meal. The mirroring. The next one is you wait, because you would, and then after that you wait 200 gram and 50 gram, different, right? 200 gram and 50 grams of brown rice for milling, okay? Mill 200 gram first of brown rice for 60 seconds using the milling machine, tester, and wait rice receive. And then make sure the electric current using the ammeter, and then the separate whole grain by using rice scatter tester for 60 seconds and head rice. And then you measure whiteness by using whiteness meter that I showed you before, and also calculate length and Y ratio for the shape. Okay. For the calculate milling yield, you can using percentage of milling rice, like using weight of new rice multiply by percentage of new rice of paddy, and then divide by weight of brown rice. This is you can get the percentage of milling rice. The next one, the percentage of head rice you use the weight of head rice multiplied by percentage of new rice of paddy, and then you divide by weight of our rice. You can get, often you can get the milling yield. For the milling capacity, how can you measure it? You can use the formula, like kilogram. This is the milling capacity in kilogram per hour. How many kilograms per hour that you can get the milling capacity? You use the weight of our rice in gram multiplied by 1 kilo. This is already derived the formula for you. So multiply by 1 kilogram, multiply by 3,600 seconds, and then divide by times, multiply by 1,000 grams, multiply by 1 hour. So this will be kilogram per hours. This is, I just derived the formula for you, but you can use this type of formula. Don't need to derive it again, okay? Just put the requested number on the formula. Inside the rice mill, not only the capacity, not only the percentage of head rice or performance like this, but you have to know the how much for energy consuming, because once you consume the energy in your process quite a lot, it means your cost is pretty high. But once you know which is you can save for energy, so you can save your money in your pocket because of the cost is lower. How can you know it? Very easy. At the, this is the basic one. Or you, if you have the equipment to check it, it's easier. But for the formula that you can calculate for the electrical power, you're using the electrical power, like you measure volt and multiply by M and then divide by 1000. In Thailand, the volt is 220, but if in your country it's not 220, you have to change this number, okay? Some is 240, okay? Some is lower, depend on each country for the volt, okay? But in Thailand is 220. For the electric efficiency, you use the other formula to calculate. The electric efficiency, kilowatt hour per kilogram, per kilogram. So you get the power in kilowatt, and then you divide by capacity, kilogram per hour that you get from the last formula. And then you can also calculate the electrical cost by, this is in, oh sorry, I put the, actually it's US dollar or baht or in your country currency, okay? Electric cost, you can use the electric efficiency multiplied by energy price, very easy. Once you calculate in series, you can get final, you can get how much you have to pay for your thing. Okay? You can try on this one. And for the milling productivity, also the milling productivity, how many tons per unit of electric that you can produce, okay? We use the milling capacity, ton per hour, divided by power, like unit kilowatt hour. And then that one you calculate for 200 gram already. So you, again, do it with 50 gram. But the 50 gram you using Neuralink machine tester for 180 seconds, and then wait it, and repeat the structure of 200 grams. Repeat the formula that I told you, and then compare between 200 and 50 grams. Okay, you can test it in your at your house, or you can use the number, estimate the number, assume the number. And then this is the table that you can check. Table check the quality. Okay. Put the number that you get from the formula that you calculate into the table, so you can see, and we have data for your rice meal. Okay. We have your data, and then this data you can put maybe in for the database in the computer. So next time when you see it, you can know, oh, which part should I improve, or which part that I lost, so you can improve your process. And this is to compare cost of nearly different feed rate. So once you get different feed rate, the cost is different. You can try it. Okay, you can try it and compare between 200 and 50. You can see the different. Okay, so this is pretty help for checking loss, for checking cost for your rice meal. The other ones, you can check the milling capacity again for the productivity, the milling capacity weight of paddy rice used, divide by time of use. Okay, you can get it, and then the power square root 3 VI cos theta divided by 1000, so you can get V is mole, I am cos theta equal to power factor, normally it's 0.8 to 0.9. Okay, it's not, one is very perfect, but not normally it's not. Your power factor should be in this range. One is very good, but normally most of cannot be one, except you improve it very good, but normally it's 0.8 and 0.9, but if lower, it means you lost your money because of it not good. Okay. So, and productivity, you can use the formula milling capacity divided by power. The energy consumption, you can use power divided by milling capacity. Okay. And the energy cost, you can use this one. Okay. Energy consumption multiplied by energy price. Okay, before I go to the new technology, I would like to give you some idea for drying technology, the drying machine. Very important also in many countries, especially also in Thailand. We have the harvest time in the same time. It's about November, December. In Thailand, this is harvest time. Nearly every year, not every farmer, they have their own dryer, so they have to share dry. This is very important because of the agriculture area at the moment, at present in Thailand, is reduced. I think some country also reduced, same as in Thailand. So that's why the dryer is very important for reducing the moisture content from the high one until to the safe one. The safe one normally in rice in 15%, right? 15%. If you should dry or reduce the moisture content lower or not above 14% or 15%. Otherwise, is we have problem when you storage, right? The first one, the dryer, you can see at you can see from the picture is have the traditional one, right? The traditional one. This is you may be very familiar because this can use in many places because the cost of construction is not pretty high and the process is very very easy to use and easy to maintenance, but it suits for the small farm or not the big one. This one you can use the low temperature. They normally use like 45-55 degrees of Celsius for this one because many farmers in Thailand they use this one because of they would like to get great seed and grain. Once you produce seed, you cannot use the temperature over 45 degrees of Celsius. Otherwise, it will affect to the growth rate. Okay, the growing rate. But if you want to produce the grains, of course you can use the high temperature. It's okay. But in Thailand, for the small farm, they would like to produce both seed and grain. So they normally use this one. This one, the cost of construction is low, but it can dry quite good, but it still take time because the temperature is not pretty high. But if you see in the picture, they have the new equipment. That's for the, I think this one probably from China. Similar to the concrete one, so it means you don't need to construct by concrete, but you use this one. It can use both the biomass and also electric. You can choose which one you would like to use. If you have a lot of hogs, you can use less hogs for the biomass to produce the hot air. And also it can control the temperature very accurately. So this one, the new equipment, but the operation is, operating is similar to the old one. And once you have bigger farm, or you have the rice milling, like for example in Thailand, we have the cooperative rice milling quite a lot. You can use that type, the flat grain dryer, but you have to move to the vertical grain dryer. The vertical grain dryer have many models. For example, in for the vertical LSU, you may know the LSU one. Actually, stand for Louisiana State University because they have the research about that. The first one, they have the a lot of things like in the they call in many like tower or even in the similar to the silo. Something like that. So it has many model for the vertical grain dryer, but it suit for the I think the in the middle like cooperative they use the RSU pilot in Thailand and then the other model as well. And also they have one they have another kind of dryer that can dry very fast, I will tell you later. And the next one is mobile grain dryer. The mobile grain is very convenient. In your country, if you have the big farm, so the mobile grain dryer can drive into your area and then, but the limit of that one is can reduce the moisture contents very short range. Cannot reduce from 22% or 24% until 14, no. You have to put to dryer. You may have to stay drying process in this case. This one that I told you, this is very quick, but the cost pretty high, same, similar to the LSU, but it's suit for the commercial one. This is we call food dice bed grain dryer. You can see in the picture. Normally, the most of the dryer is flat, like batch or flat. We call batch dryer. It's not move. The patty is not move. But this one, once it's operating, the patty will lift up into the air. When it's lift up into the air, it mean it can be change the thermal with the air very quick. So that why if you use the traditional for drying for 2 days, for example, this one use only 30 minutes, very quick. But they can use only patty is okay, the corn is okay, the particle should be the same size, cannot be different size. So this is the limit for this one. And because of it can use high temperature, sometimes 150 degrees of Celsius can use it, 130 degrees of Celsius can use it. So once the structure inside patty, that inside rice can it have the heat up enough above about 70 degrees of Celsius, it will change, it will melt. You can see the three picture at the bottom lines, the first one is different, like don't heat anything. The middle one is heat up by 130 degrees of Celsius. And the last one is heat up by 150 degrees of Celsius. So it's melt. Once it's melt, it will cover the spread inside the rice structure. This is very good because once you take into the milling process, you can get higher head like yield. Okay? Higher head like yield. So this very popular as well instead of LSU, and this installed not only in Thailand but also other country as well. I will show you. This is a from the original road. This one is not a food. Okay, I will go faster. This one, this is my research cooperate with the farmer in one province in Thailand, and now already extend to other. Normally in Thailand, we have, as I told you, we have the problem about the area of drying rice. Sometimes they put the shade dry on the street. It's not good. It can contaminate. It can have the accident and whatever, because they don't have the area much right now. So I help them. They have the rice barn in their farm. So I change, I put the drying process, the drying set into the rice barn of them. And then this one can grind and keep it in the same time. Okay, can help them. And right now, is extend to many part of Thailand already. And this one in my university we also produce because right now the many people, Thai people, they would like to produce rice by themselves. So they bought the area and then produce rice, and then they would like to have a small milling machine. So we produce it for them. This is very small, so you can use in your household, in your kitchen, very easy. This one, okay. And this one, I would like to show you that we have this type of new technology using the radio frequency to kill the insect like rice bee inside the rice meal already. This is already implemented in the cooperative rice meal in Surin province already. The company they call Yen Peng Di. So now they have two capacity for your choice. The first one, the capacity is lower, like 200 to 300 ton per hour, for example, and the cost is about 2 million baht. And the bigger one is about 4 million baht, but the capacity is bigger. This one just show you a little bit. How Yen Peng Di or
สวัสดีครับวันนี้ผมอยู่ที่สตสุรินทร์นะครับ
This is I just would like to show you that they already installed inside the rice meal. That's okay. This is just to show you they already installed and okay.
จะมาส่งมอบเครื่องไบโอคิวหรือว่าเป็นเครื่องกำจัดมอดตลอดจนชีวิตด้วยคลื่นวิทยุนะครับซึ่งรุ่นนี้เป็นรุ่นที่2แล้วนะครับที่เราได้ถ่ายทอดเทคโนโลยีมาจากมหาวิทยาลัยเชียงใหม่ซึ่งถือเป็นนวัตกรรมแห่งแรกของโลกที่เราสามารถจะนำมาใช้กำจัดมอดด้วยวิธีการที่ไม่ใช้สารเคมีนะครับเดี๋ยวเราไปดูกันเลยนะครับว่าที่นี่เราจะทำอะไรกันในการส่งมอบครับเชิญครับ
This one we don't use the chemical, but we use the radio frequency instead of chemical to kill the living. This I told you that everything right now is on the mobile phone already. Even this one you can see the real time for the temperature, real time for the frequency. So how the process already.I've been done today on the air to move down there, very convenient.
Okay.
Maybe a few slides. Just would like to show you that we use the infrared fluorescence techniques.Okay, this one we use the fluorescence techniques to catch up the degree of milling, and also you see inside the picture right now we can use the fluorescence techniques. The fluorescence is mean the wave, right? The wave of the light wave of range. You can see the fluorescence.Even in this I do my research with the Kyoto University. This is normally, if you see by your eyes, you can detect in just some part. You cannot detect some very deep part But once you use this side of techniques, even in the orange, you can see the rotten parts of the orange. Also, we use in the same techniques for the rice as well. This is we use for we would like to know how deep of the whitening from the branch into the surface, which one is suitable, as I told you in at first. So we renew the rice in different deep, and then we mature it by using the first sense technique. For this technique, you can see how deep, and also you can see how much of proteins or other kind of thing that stuck on your, that left on your rice. So it's very, very good, very helpful for you that you can see, oh, you still have some nutrition on the rice indeed. In this deep, in the surface, if we take the branch only this millimeter, okay. And also, we can also use the first sense technique in terms of we take off alpha toxin, B1, B2 on rice, and we can see the alpha toxin. And this one very useful for the, if you would like to export your rice to other countries. This is very important. Instead of you use only the last techniques, but this one very helpful as well. Okay, this is my last slide. Thank you very much for your high attention, and if you have any questions, please feel free.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
very much for the next lecture from Dr. Dolly Chen in the morning session for the Thailand technology in rice manufacturing. We have got a lot of background information of Thailand development in the machinery of the how to process of the rice product in Thailand. This is the Q&A session for our colleagues and participants in this training course. If you have any ideas, any kinds of any discussion or any questions, you feel free to ask for our administration, and then we will try to answer and follow with your ideas and questions. Yes, please. Are there any questions? You can text the chat message as well, like yesterday. The first question is, what is the idea of rice monitors content of grain to decrease working rice? Rice monitor content.
Okay. Once, actually the sale moisture content is 14%, right? But if you reduce it lower than that, it means the weight. You lost the weight. You lost, and it's very easily for broken as well if it's very dry. So better keep it in like in the safe moisture content as much as you can do it. But otherwise, you can use other kind of techniques. That's I told you. Maybe you can produce in terms of parboiled rice. For the parboiled rice, you can get higher, very high. Because of the structure inside the rice itself. It melts, as you see in the slide, it melts and then it will be harder for broken. So you can, maybe you use, first use the like not lower than 14 much, and the second or you improve the process.
Thank you very much, Professor Dolly, for your asking about rice. Next question is how to limit the losses during the rice processing. I think there are many the rice bill. So the question from our colleagues from Central Center, how to limit the losses?
Okay, for the losses, start from once you harvest, you lost your paddy in the field already, right? But if you have the drying, as I improve the rice barn for the Thai farmer, if you have rice barn already, you put the drying process inside the rice barn, you only lost one set because you bring your paddy from fields and then you put into the barns, your barns. You don't need to put in the shed dry. If you put in shed dry and then you bring it to barn, you have two sets for losing that one. But if you move from your field and then put it in the barn and then dry it and then keep it in the same time before you sell it, so it will cut the loss process of this one.
Okay, thank you very much. I see from question again, the admin, can you add up to the above questions before we move it? Yeah, I think two questions is the same, like about drying device and moisture content. Can the moisture content of the paddy can be determined by mobile application? So the mobile application as an individual can control the moisture.
The mobile phone is only the receiver. You have to understand. It's not like that you can shape, you can calculate by shape from camera from your mobile. But moisture content need the equipment to detect because it use the electrical method of different amount of water inside the product, and then it will measure by using the method of electric, and then send that data to your mobile phone. This can be possible, but it cannot possible if you use your mobile only use the camera from your mobile and then measure the moisture content. It cannot. You have to have the equipment to detect the moisture content, and then send from that equipment to your mobile via boxes that I told you.
I see. Thank you very much, Doctor. The next question may be the question from there's lots of questions. By finishing of the question, may I go on to the above question, please? There is the question from our next. It's slide number 16, our question from Myanmar participant. How is chalky grain?
Not good.
Why?
Because chalky grain is some kind of the protein inside the rice is not normal.
I see.
In normal angle. So this is not in the commercial, they don't like the chalky grain.
I see.
Okay, rice should be transparency, like you have to see through the rice through the your light. Yes, and when once you have it, so the chalky is not good. But except for other kind, some kind of rice, for example, the glutinous rice. That's one. The color is different because it is not transparency. It's different. But for the normal rice, no.
Okay, thank you. What is the difference between rice meal consumed in Thailand and rice meal export to other countries like African countries?
In Thailand, we can produce more than the consumer in Thailand can produce. They can would like to get, if we say like 40-50% consumed in Thailand, but the other we can export. Then we can produce more than we consume in Thailand. So maybe same as in Africa, you can also produce the basmati in some country, right? You can produce more basmati in some country and then you export it. But for the other rice, you have to import also from my country. If you see the rice in your country from Thailand, most of them is parboy rice. Parboy rice is more like they have the good condition for parboy rice can keep longer than normal rice. So that's why you import parboy rice from Thailand quite a lot.
Thank you very much. The next will be asking for about the. Is there any quality standard of rice? I think this question may be moving to tomorrow because we have a topic on standard in rice manufacturing. Yeah. And the next is, I want to know what kinds of application is applying in Thailand during this time with the pandemic to control the high quality of the rice manufacturing.
Yeah. Actually, in Thailand, we have the standard, which is tomorrow you will study about this one. But I just say, in every rice mill, if you would like to export or sell, I don't mean the traditional one, okay? For the commercial one, you should meet the standard, at least GMP, good manufacturing practice, okay? So tomorrow you will study about it, and then the lecture will tell you about this. And for the application, of course, we have applications start from production, like in the fields. Right now we have application we call rice weller in Thailand. So it can estimate since you produce your rice. Okay, next year, if I produce 10 rice, for example, of rice, will I get benefit or not? So you can estimate from that kind of application. In Thailand already have.
We relating to the satellite that
yes.
we have in Thailand to looking for the cropping in Thailand.
Yeah. And we do the big data long time. So right now we have enough data to get. Very important thing that if you want to establish one application, it means you need a lot of data. But in Thailand, we collect the data long time. So that's why we can produce the application using that kind of data.
That should be the step of the development of technologies as well. Yeah, the next may be, I have question concerning vertical and mobile dryer, which is more better in terms of the rice quality? Vertical and mobile dryer.
It's different purpose. The mobile is for your convenience to bring to dry one step from your field. Okay, if you reduce from 22, for example, 22%, maybe until 18% from using mobile, and then you have to check it and use vertical to reduce from 18 until save like 14%. So it have to be two steps.
This one is moisture content, and we already talking about the moisture.
Bio-Q. Yes, bio-Q. Of course. Already used in Thailand, this kind of techniques, in Surin Cooperative rice mill in one province in Thailand. And the capacity is pretty high. And that one, they produce one of the best, I can say one of the best rice in Thailand. Normally from Surin.
I see a lot of messages, questions at this moment. Maybe we can keep for a while and we have a break, and during the second half of our lecture today, we will continue for your questions. We will ask it by our Professor Dolly and followed by the lecture of the traditional and modern technology of rice factory in the our lecture. So that is for me. Thank you very much, everyone, participants, colleagues around the world to join us at the training call, training to enhance manufacturing technology and to improve productivity in rice field factory. At the topic of the rice technology of rice mill on topic on lecture number 3 in this moment, we have around 1.5 hours for break. So we will come back again about 1 and I'm confused the time difference now. It will be 1 p.m. in Thailand. In Thailand, so we have more about 1 hour to have a short break, and we will meet you again at 1 hour later on. Okay, see you later on. May I request that maybe you can join us before we start the meeting, so that you can have the time to chat with our professor. Okay, thank you, everyone. Have a nice break in.